The Philippine eagle is known as one of the world's largest raptors and is the apex predator of the Philippine forests. However, throughout the years, their numbers have dwindled to the point that they were almost extinct. But thanks to the efforts of the Philippine Eagle Foundation, in 1992, the birth of Pag-asa and his brother Pagkakaisa alerted the world that the Philippine eagle, as a species, is not a lost cause. Their hatching proved that through our efforts, the conservation of these magnificent raptors is still within reach. As such, we are lucky to meet one of the people who are directly responsible for conserving and breeding our Philippine eagles here at the Philippine Eagle Center. I'm here at the Philippine Eagle Center right now, so here, and we will be talking to the first ever woman in the world to work with Philippine eagles, Luana Halak. So I hope you enjoy our content for today, and hopefully you like and subscribe our subsequent videos. See ya! So, hi, can you introduce yourself and tell us a bit more about your work here at the Philippine Eagle Foundation?
Yeah, so my name is Luana. I am an animal keeper and eagle trainer here at the Philippine Eagle Foundation.
When you first started working with them, was there an adjustment period, or does the Philippine eagle have any notable differences in behavior or working with them as compared to the other raptors that you work with?
So yeah, that's a great question. The Philippine eagles in general, they have a dominant personality, so they are the apex predator in their environment, so that's reflective in their behavior. And so working with Philippine eagles, it can be quite dangerous because they are, one, a large bird of prey, and two, because of that dominant personality, they can be seen as more aggressive in comparison to other birds of prey species. So for Philippine eagles, when I first started working with them to develop that initial bond for my imprinted eagles, I kind of was outside the enclosure first, kind of got to know them, allowed them to get to know me in that sense before I was able to enter their enclosure and then be able to interact with them in that way. Compared to smaller raptors where you can manipulate their behavior in a sense because you can hold them on the glove a lot easier because they are small based on their size, but for Philippine eagles, they are large. And what I'm trying to say is like some eagles will like you, some eagles won't. Like Mabuhay doesn't like me, kind of straight up. They'll remember that you did something wrong to them.
Okay. How do you think your role as an animal keeper for the conservation breeding program helps in the general mission of the Philippine Eagle Foundation, which is the conservation and breeding of our Philippine eagles?
Working within the conservation breeding program, our ultimate goal is to propagate the species in a captive setting to ultimately be part of a reintroduction program back into the wild. Mm-hmm. So we're trying to propagate the species, and in doing so, we're literally saving the species from extinction, right? So we don't want them to go extinct in any means.
Yes, of course.
However, with our program, what we want to do is, although we propagate them in captivity, we want to allow them to have a wild and like free life. So for those that do remain in our captive settings, they are the breeders to hopefully produce offspring to release in the wild.
Okay, thank you. So what do you think is hampering Philippine eagle breeding and conservation efforts today?
From the conservation breeding side of it, it would be the Philippine eagle's biology, per se, in terms of producing one egg every 2 years. That's typically in the wild, but also the incubation period, it takes long, their slow maturation rates. They basically have a slow life history. So everything kind of takes time, and then there's a lot of other complicating factors that can affect that.
Last question before I let you go. Back to breeding and conservation. What can we be optimistic or excited about regarding the future of our Philippine eagles?
Well, hopefully producing more eaglets that will eventually be released. We want more people to be able to understand why these species are needed in our ecosystems, in their habitat, and not to hurt them or inhibit any way for them to not breed on their own naturally. So either taking away eaglets from their nests or shooting our Philippine eagles. We want to avoid all that. So awareness is definitely key, creating a safe space for our Philippine eagles to breed naturally in the wild. So we want that to happen. And then for our conservation breeding department here, we just want to produce more and also have them be healthy so that they can have offspring to be back in the wild. Yeah.
Okay, thank you. Thank you so much, Luana. So you can say bye-bye to the people. Luana and the conservation breeding team of the Philippine Eagle Foundation cannot save the species alone. To save an eagle, it takes a team. However, to save an entire species, it takes a country. Conserving and breeding our Philippine eagles in captivity is only the first step towards saving their species, and only we can continue their mission.